We're moments away from puck drop here on CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN. Stuart Bowden taking you through all the action in today's final RSEQ regular season matchup, both the GGs and the Ravens heading to the playoffs next week. Scratches for today's game for Carleton: Victoria Powers, third string goaltender; number 4, Jasmine Levesque; number 5, Victoria Gramuska, both out, as well as Victoria Gooch, number 8, number 11, Michelle Zimmer. For the GGs, Caitlin Fowler, third string goaltender, scratched today; number 6, Vanessa Grimoso; number 8, Catherine Scicotti; and number 63, Lauren Cox. And Tia Marley is the backup goaltender today to Stephanie Mercier. She started the game against Concordia yesterday. She made 20 saves on 24 shots, allowing 4 goals before being lifted in favor of Mercier. Yannick Ivola is the head coach of the GGs. They will meet up with the number 2 ranked team in the country, the McGill Martlets, in the first round of the playoffs. The schedule yet to be determined for next week. The Ravens will take on the Caravan de Montréal starting Wednesday at Sepsum, Friday at Carleton, and if necessary, back at Sepsum in Montreal on Sunday. Our game officials for today: referee Jeff Demers, linespeople Pat Gagnon and Megan Lamont. This is the 5th meeting between these two teams this season. The GGs have owned the Ravens, winning all 4 games, and with a 6-13 record, if the GGs could have put a couple more victories together, they may have leapt over the Ravens for third place in the conference. Demers calls the Senators to the dot, and we're underway. In her own zone, Beaver headmans a pass to Lasseline, who dumps it in. Mercier out to set it up, where quickly back for it is Watson, the young rookie. Played up the sideboards, where it's kept in momentarily. Delange now moves it up to DeLinardo. Ravens getting their first change in as Bergeron off the bench backhands it in to the feet of Delange. She plays it up and hit Blomberg. Now a giveaway in the neutral zone, and an offside indicated as Yaluz was just offside as she brought that puck in. And our first whistle just 26 seconds into our opening period. Seiler out with Wagner and Bergeron, the top line for the Ravens. They win the draw and attempt to dump it in, but it's stopped there by Porcellato. She had a goal along with DeForge in yesterday's matchup in Montreal against the Stingers. Seiler not able to settle the puck down, not allowed Porcellato to pick it up. Now moving over and lead pass through to Lefebvre. Lefebvre on the left side, off the post, the shot by Fanny DeForge, as she had beat Tamber Tisdale glove side, but couldn't get it past the iron, and the puck rolls all the way back down into the GG zone. Porcellato trying to start the breakout. That's turned over, and now Boucher will move it up. She's slowly through her own zone, dishes off the right side, looking there for Kohlfeldt. Now through the middle, Pouliot on the left side. She'll lift it in. Tisdale kind of misplayed that. So play continues now in the offensive zone. That puck played down by LeClaire, and it missed defenseman Delfino. And the GGs will have to head all the way back into their own zone. The Ravens on the attack. Now behind the net, Delfino moving it up. She'll play it back now, down low to Standis. The GGs taking their time in their own end, allowing the Ravens to get a forecheck established. Now Kohlfeldt's got a little bit of room on the right side. She'll bang it off the boards into the neutral zone. Beaver going to fire it right back in. Mercier settles that down for her D. Maria Standish reverses the puck to Delfino. Delfino up the boards where it's kept in momentarily. Now out in the neutral zone for Seiler. She played it back. It skipped over the stick of Beaver, and she'll have to retreat. On the right side, Wagner plays through the middle, looking for Young, had it bounce off her skate. Just outside her blue line, Delange one-hands it up onto the stick of Bouchard. Little saucer pass there by Watson. Didn't connect. Now Bouchard will just hammer it in the zone. Tisdale will let it go as Monarch's back for the Blackbirds. Watson not able to keep it in at the point, but she's got some skating room and she carries in. Dishes on the right side for Paquette. Paquette spins away from the check, plays it back to Delange. Now Paquette tried to play it into the corner for Delinardo. Delinardo rubbed off by Monarch, and Simpson and Bouchard battle in the corner as well. Delange wrist shot, steered aside by Tisdale. Blomberg intercepted that pass, tries to walk out. It bounces through the crease. And now Tisdale's going to get her glove on it and slow this game down. And she'll hang on for a whistle. 16:24 to go here in the opening period. The GGs and Ravens tied at zero here at the Sports Complex in Ottawa. Faceoff coming to the right of Tamber Tisdale, who's established herself as the number one goaltender for the Carleton Ravens. Erie Kirabuchi will start tomorrow. Coach Shelley Coolidge has already informed Tisdale that she will have the game off against Montreal. That pass didn't connect with anybody and slides down the ice. No icing indicated. So Boucher will have to be the first one back. She turns it over in the corner to Kent. Long cross ice pass for DeFord. She rang one off the goalpost in her last shift. This time she tries to put it through the screen of Monarch. Behind the net, Tisdale steers it back behind the goal line where Lefebvre picks it up. DeForge back to the point. Standis slaps it. It's tipped by Lefebvre. Ends up going wide in the net. Now Beaver. That hit a skate. And again, Tisdale seen enough of this puck in her own end. She'll hang on for another whistle. Danny DeForge, who had that great scoring chance early on, leading scorer for the GGs. Now Bergeron, the leading scorer for the Ravens, comes the other way. Bergeron shot deflected high and off one of the pillars on the ceiling. And a whistle coming. Faceoff will remain inside. Bergeron, 7 goals, 5 assists on the campaign. Off the draw, given away, and Wagner had a chance to carry it in. That puck shot wide by Bergeron as she was in tight and didn't get a whole lot to look at. Long pass off the sideboards behind Caulfield. B-Mac will head in for it. Now Beaver plays it up, comes outside as Porcellato brought it back in, and an offside call. Slow start here to today's game, both teams feeling each other out, but I'm sure the intensity will pick up momentarily, as it always does between these two teams. Their last matchup was back January 14th here at the Sports Complex. The GG skating out with a 3-1 victory. Mercier is getting spun around in her crease as she dives back and forth. The Ravens bang at the puck. And now, moving it up with a backhand pass is Boucher. Reinholtz heads in. Now the Ravens come the other way as the speed starts to pick up. Kristen McDonald, she's got Brittany Simpson with her. She cuts in the middle. Her wrist shot steered aside by Mercier. Kent, just off the bench, leaves it at the point for McKnight. Her shot in, and Kristen McDonald was right there looking for the rebound, so Mercy had to play it away. Ravens D looking for a change. That forced McDonald just to throw it through the crease. Plude keeps it in at the point, but now skating the other way is Standis. She makes one move around Kent. Standis by herself trying to buy some time as her teammates come off a line change. Plude gets rubbed out by Delinardo. Kent now in, battling against number 89 for the GGs. Watson, cross ice pass. Shot deflected in on net. Tisdale hangs on to it. and had it long enough for a whistle. 13:22 to go here in period one. Still no score between the Ravens and the Gigi's. The Gigi's with the most pressure so far in today's game, including a shot that won't count on the score clock from Fanny DeForge. The Gigi's controlled off the draw, played out front. And lastly, we'll just play it high off the glass. We're picking it up is Vanderveen. She cuts in, fans on the shot. Mercier was made that save, and they were able to clear the rebound. Now down the other way, Delange, her shot just over the glove of Tisdale, and that's the second one that Tisdale has missed to the glove side. DeForge bangs with Beaver. DeForge goes down. Beaver first on the puck, pokes it away from Lefebvre. Around the other side, BMAC. Boucher keeps it in. Now DeForge tried to go the wrist shot and had it knocked off her stick. Behind the net, Vanderveen. Over to BMAC. Looking through the center. Pass was behind Seiler. And the Gigi is able to counterattack. DeForge flips it in. Lefebvre and McKnight. At the blue line, DeForge able to keep it in, but it'll only be momentarily as Wegner gets it out. Caulfield in her own zone. Over to her D partner, Boucher. Gives it away as Yalouz picked it off and flips it back in. Porcellato back for it. Looking to break it out at the blue line. It's kept in by the Ravens. That pass flipped high through the slot, so no one able to get a stick on it. McKnight pulls the puck across the blue line, dishes it off for Yalouz. Knocked off her stick, but right to Kristen McDonald. McDonald to Yalouz. Her shot went wide. She was looking a tip there from Young. Now they keep it in. A diving play there, and the Gigi's are going to get it out. Caulfield just flips it in, and she's first on the puck. LeClaire heads behind the net as support. Now a giveaway through the middle. Caulfield turned and spun, was blocked there by O'Grady. Knocked down, no high stick indicated. Caulfield's dumped. Now McKnight gets away from LeClaire. Plays it off the board. Standis kept it in, and she got help from Caulfield. Caulfield's been out there for a long shift. Standis back down for Pouliot. Pouliot shot. Nice tip by Caulfield, but it went wide. But she tipped it between her legs on the pass from Pouliot. Now Kent gets to the red line and dumps it in, and the Ravens will go for a full line change. Claudia Bergeron stays out there on the attack. Lasseline, fresh off the bench, loses it in the corner. Bergeron ran into Reinholtz. And now Standis tried to make a move, but it was knocked off her stick by Lasseline. Vanderveen in the corner, tries to get it out front to Bergeron. Bergeron behind the net, tries to walk out with it, but too many white jerseys there for her to get it through. Plude dumps it in behind the net. Bergeron wraps it around, and it again went through the crease. No Carleton players there in the slot where all those passes seem to be going through. Reinholtz tied up by Kristen McDonald. Plude over to pick up the loose puck. McDonald behind the net, over to Monarch, up for Seiler, not strong on her stick, so that puck gets knocked back down. Plude over to Monarch. Monarch pressured there by Morrison. Seiler now leads the rush for Carleton, passes it up to McDonald where it's turned away. B. McDonald over to Beaver, now up the left side. Gigi's come the other way. B. Mack will flip it back in. Delange makes one move around McDonald, now another one. She'll get to the blue line and dump it in. B. Mack goes back for the Ravens, got away from Blomberg. At the point, Watson shot, hit somebody, nobody knew where it was. Tisdale was looking behind the net as it sat in the crease. Now Yalouz, one-on-one against Watson. Alex Yalouz goes to the outside. Now she'll go around the net, passes out front, but it hit a skate and went in back below the goal line. Got some great end-to-end action here. Both teams with lots of chances. At the point, McKnight's shot blocked. And now bringing the puck the other way is Choyne. She's got a game-winning goal against these Ravens. And as she flips it in, Tisdale will hang on and cover the puck for a face-off. 8:15 to go. 0-0 is our score. Period number one. The GGs and the Ravens renewing their rivalry. Choyne didn't have the game-winning goal in that 3-1 victory against Carleton back on January 14th. McKnight, nice little move around to Forge. Lost it at the blue line. It's played up over the glass right in front of the scorekeeper's booth. Now a one-on-two. Kristen McDonald tries to make a move around Boucher. Wasn't able to work. A turnover in the neutral zone. Lefebvre chops it in, but DeForge was offside, so she'll have to clear the zone, allowing the Ravens to bring it out. Delfino curls a couple times in her own zone, looking for an outlet. She finds one in the form of Caulfield on the right side. Caulfield's pass hit the linesman, now Pouliot. She'll just slowly flip it in on net. Tisdale will hang on to it, and we'll take another whistle. Face-off will come to the right of Tisdale. One thing over the past games between the Ravens and the Gigi's have dominated the face-off circle. So Ravens have to improve on that if they want to have a chance in today's game. And they're able to win the draw there, but not able to get it out. Pouliot in the corner, plays it around, was looking for Caulfield and went too far. And McDonald tried to get it up to the breaking Wagner. Now a chance for Seiler. Seiler carries it in. And a glove save by Stephanie Mercier. She snagged that shot from Sarah Seiler with the glove hand. And she'll hang on for the faceoff. Mercier, the rookie out of Smooth Rock Falls. I just like saying that. It's a great little town. I've never been there, but sounds like it'd be a cool place to be from. Wagner through center. Dumps it in. Dumped around. Now through the neutral zone. Played in. McDonald trying to get it out. That's Sidmack. Yalouz plays it back. And it'll go all the way around the net for O'Grady. She can't poke it out. Lefebvre winds and fires. And again, Tisdale can't hang on to that with her glove. Tamber Tisdale normally very good with that glove hand. Been a little bit shaky here in the early going of today's game. Morrison on O'Grady. She squeezes her out. Reinholtz off the bench. Digs for the loose puck. It's underneath. And now trying to carry it out. It went through the legs of Tisdale, but through the blue paint. Watson keeps it in. And now a break coming the other way. One-on-one as Reinholtz is on the back check. And a good effort by McDonald. And she gets run over in the front of the net by Jody Reinholtz. And we're going to get our first power play of today's game as Sydney McDonald, after she got that shot on net, went to the front and was taken out by Jody Reinholtz. It's going to be a roughing call to Reinholtz at the 14:03 mark. The Carleton power play ranks last in the conference, only operating at 16.9%, 12 goals in 71 chances, and they've given up 3 shorthanded goals, the most in the conference. Ottawa is a very good penalty kill. They rank only behind the McGill Martlets. They're at 82.3%. They've got 1 shorthanded goal. There's a tip. It's loose. Mercier's down. They battle for it. No whistle. Referee's right there. And finally, the puck is covered. So they haven't been able to get the penalty time up. So both coaches will have to be aware of when Reinholtz comes out of the box. Faceoff is going to stay inside the zone. And now they have it up, but it's got the wrong time up there. Jody Reinholtz takes her 18th minute in penalties. So the graduating senior, not wanting to spend a lot of her last regular season game in the penalty box. So now they've instructed both coaches to ignore the penalty time as they try to figure that out. Off the draw, that's won by the Ravens. And Mercier gets her glove out and makes that save. That's usually something we see in the preseason with a clock problem, but hopefully we can get that corrected as we head through the rest of the game. Lassalin in against Blomberg. One back. That shot just went wide as BMAC fired it in. Now Bergeron dumps it off. Beaver plays it down low. Lassalin's pressured there. Blomberg pins her against the boards. They can't get it out. BMAC throws it in on net. And a great tip there. And Bergeron just had to roll off her stick as she tried to make the deke. Lassalin plays it out front, looking for Vanderveen. Vanderveen swings at it. Now two GGs come the other way. Blomberg will dump it in. BMAC hustles back for it, where Blomberg keeps an eye on her. Down the left side, Kristen McDonald's got some skating room. She's out there with Wegner and Seiler. She cuts to the right. Now she'll look to set it up. She hits the brakes. Tied up along the board, Seiler. Back to the point, O'Grady just keeps it in. Wegner into the corner for Seiler. Seiler tries to get it out front. Stolen there by Watson. Plays down. Tisdale out to play it away from Caulfield. And that allows Wegner to play it down low. McKnight starting the rush out for the Ravens. Up to Bergeron. Bergeron down the right side. She just softly dumps it into the corner. Stannis plays it around. Now it's back up and out of the zone. Plude on the right side for McKnight. McKnight makes one move around Watson. Penalty is now over. And that shot's blocked. And a 2-on-0 coming. DeForge plays it up onto the stick of Pouliot. Erica Pouliot fires it and it goes just wide as she tried to go low blocker on Tamara Tisdale. But just as the penalty ended, the GGs may have, or the Ravens may have been confused with the time on the clock. Now Yalou's coming the other way. She'll drifted in just wide as she was on a one-on-one. There's a big collision and a penalty coming. It's going to go again to the GGs. Heading off is going to be number 56, Mary-France Boucher, as she stepped into Chelsea Young, who carried the puck in. And after killing off the first two-minute penalty, the Ravens will go right back to the player advantage. Now they've got the penalty up. So with 3:22 to go here in a scoreless first period, the Ravens on their second power play. They had fairly good control in the first with a couple scoring chances, but gave up a 2-on-0 break right as the penalty expired. And Tisdale held her ground and forced Pouliot to shoot it wide. Now Stannis looking to kill off some time. She'll backhand it into the Ravens zone. Lefebvre on the attack. Watches BMAC there, who dishes it off to Sarah Seiler. The captain of the Ravens, carries it in over the line, hits the brakes, makes a nice move, now looking for some help as she's watched by Maria Standis. At the point, O'Grady dishes it off. Spinning away is McKnight. They want to try to set McKnight up on that one-timer. With that shot she's got from the point, Lefebvre able to fire it off the boards and down the ice. 56 seconds remaining in the Boucher minor. On the right side, Krista McDonald couldn't handle the pass, and the GGs get it out to center. McKnight in front of her own bench. Plays it up for Wegner. Wegner backhands it in. And an icing call indicated, and a faceoff all the way back inside the Ravens zone. And Shelley Coolidge cannot be too happy with that as her team on the power play ices the puck. 2 minutes and 3 seconds to go here in period number one. The GGs killing a penalty right now, but have the faceoff in the Ravens zone. Ravens control, and Wegner is going to send it all the way in. Mercier took that on the blocker, gave it to Porcellato, who sent it almost the length of the ice. Picked off by Monarch, played up, but out of the reach for Lasseline, and Watson in on it. That puck knocked down by Monarch at the blue line, and Delinardo in a race against Plude. Only 5 seconds to go, so the GGs have killed off another odd player opportunity. Vanderveen comes to center. She'll dump it in. Mercier sets it up, but Kent first on it for the Ravens. She was looking for Seiler, who was coming off the bench. She got deflected back into Ravens territory and played up by Beaver. Kent heading the wrong direction as she goes behind her own net to Simpson, to Seiler. 1 minute to go here as DeForge carries it in. Her shot right on, and Tisdale gloves that, makes the save with just 50.8 seconds to go here in the first period. No other games in the Quebec Conference today. There will be two tomorrow as Concordia heads to McGill and Montreal heads to Carleton for the last games of the regular season. Out to center, DeForge. DeForge back to the point. Watson, her shot's blocked and got tipped wide. Back to the point. It's Choyne and Delange exchange passes. There's good puck movement by the GGs late in the first period. And now the Ravens just happy to clear the zone. But the GG's not done yet, as here comes Delane. She's got DeForge going to the front. Hit a skate right onto the stick of DeForge. Now Beaver goes off the boards looking for Wegner. Icing's going to be called. And with just 0.7 seconds left, not a lot of time for the GG's. Their only hope is to slap it forward and hopefully catch Tisdale. Mercier is going to head to the bench for an extra attacker. Yannick Evola and I both thinking the same way. DeForge is going to slap the puck forward. And now it's going to be Caulfield. She's going to try to go forward. The left shot, and a good play by Wegner to go down and block that shot as the puck goes into the corner. And that'll do it for the first period, an exciting first period between these two in-town rivals. But after one period of play, we're scoreless here on CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN. Welcome back to CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN 00. The Ravens and the GGs through one period of play. Wanted to update you with shots on goal, but the system still has us remaining in the first period, so I will keep refreshing that, and we'll get you the shots on goal as soon as they become available. Carleton 0-4-2 on the power play in the first period. The GGs yet to be able to have a player advantage. The fifth and final meeting in the regular season between these two teams. If they were to meet in the playoffs, that would mean that both teams are headed to the national championship as two berths are at stake for the Quebec Conference. The Ravens win the opening faceoff, and after the puck gets dumped in their own zone, Sarah Seiler comes through the middle. She'll dump it in on the backhand. Maria Standish quickly in and retrieving it. Lefebvre dives for it just out of her reach. Now Seiler flips it through, and Delfino didn't want to touch that puck and deflected it in on her own net, so she let it go to the corner. Back to the point, O'Grady over to McKnight. McKnight looking for Wagner, and could see the frustration there. She shook her stick as the puck hopped over it. Kristen McDonald slowed that down. O'Grady just puts it deep into the corner as the Ravens are heading off on a change. So now that gives Standis some skating room. Puck hits some water, and Mercier had to be sharp on that kick save. She got the right pad out. Now Lasseline for Bergeron. Lasseline was looking for Vanderveen, but her stick got knocked out of her hands momentarily. Bergeron looking for some help out front. That puck gets stuck in the water. Bergeron picks it up again. Over there from Monarch. Monarch tries to get it through, and Bergeron had an empty cage and just had the puck skip on her as she went to bury it behind Mercier, who was out of position. Now the Gigi's looking to get out and get a change. Lefebvre plays it to the open side. Monarch quickly back in, but Bergeron still in the zone, and an offside call. And we'll explain why there's still a lot of water on the ice. After the buzzer sounded, we had a shootout between a young minor girls team and third string goaltender Caitlin Fowler. And that caused Zamboni to get out late, meaning that the water didn't have a chance to set up. So far it's affected the Gigi's more than the Ravens, as twice the pucks got stuck in the water in the Gigi's zone. Watson now. Watson carrying it out, couldn't get past Chalouse. Puck sent down the length of the ice, and icing indicated. And that faceoff is going to come all the way back into the Gigi's zone. Lasseline and Paquette, a pair of threes, in to take the faceoff. One back by Paquette, and a pass looking for DeLeonardo. She's got a step on Beaver, but it's knocked off her stick. That is a set play that the GGs run on a faceoff, and in one of the earlier games at the Ice House at Carleton, it worked twice. Once in regulation in order to help them tie the game, and then once on a Fanny DeForge goal in overtime. And the Ravens still have to be reminded of that faceoff alignment and what happens, and DeLeonardo had a great chance. Now LeClaire, look for DeLeonardo in the slot, played away. Tisdale got her stick down and played in the corner. McKnight, it's poked out. And now Wagner tries to hacky sack it up the ice, but it doesn't get all the way through. McKnight in her own zone, through the middle. Nice touch pass by Seiler, and Krista McDonald on a breakaway. Pouliot trying to get back, and Krista McDonald buries that behind Stephanie Mercier, giving the Ravens a 1-0 lead. But give credit to Sarah Seiler, who one-touched that pass through with an incredible backhand pass off the pass from McKnight. .312, the time of the goal for Carleton. Now McDonald from Seiler and McKnight. More importantly, the Ravens draw first blood in today's game. For McDonald, her ninth on the season. Gigi's on the attack, looking to tie this game up. Behind the net, O'Grady. Played up. They get it out. Wagner now off the boards, and now Seiler's got a step. Standis dives and able to make a good defensive play there to keep it away from Seiler. Delfino stops behind her own net. Leaves it for LeClaire. LeClaire picks it up as the Ravens were making changes. Over to the far side, Standis. Vanderveen just pokes it in. Lasseline. Out front is Bergeron. She spins and fires, and Mercier got across and made that save. There's another shot. Goes through the slot. The Ravens have come out here in this second period with a whole ton of offense as they've controlled the puck in the GG zone right in front of our broadcast position here. Now the GG's come the other way. LeClaire just flips it in. Tisdale steers it aside. Vanderveen was looking to connect with Sydney McDonald. Now Bouchard behind the net, over for Delange. Watson turned it over. Mercier didn't know where it was, and a rebound and a great save by Mercier. That shot, and Mercier gets her glove on it as it was blocked by Beaver. But what an incredible left pad save by Stephanie Mercier as she got over and made the save after Watson turned it over behind the net. Off the draw, deflected back, and Beaver has it outside the blue line. She'll dump it in, and they'll clear the zone. Again, a turnover, and now Watson just chips it out, forcing BMAC to go back for it. Off the boards, and it skips over Delange's stick. Watson will come over to support her D partner. She'll play it back. Now up on the right side, DeForge. DeForge carries down the right side. Lefebvre's with her. DeForge to the outside, getting around O'Grady. McKnight in the far corner. Couldn't poke it past Boucher, who had pinched. Now Boucher loses her stick as she battles with O'Grady. O'Grady, cross-ice pass onto the stick of Vanderveen. Vanderveen carries it in. Shot, rebound, and she scores! Brittany Simpson picks up the rebound off the shot of Kelsey Vanderveen, and the Ravens, with two quick goals here in the second period, have jumped out to a 2-0 lead over the home Ottawa Gigi's. So goals at 3:12 and 6:04. Yannick Evola may look at using his timeout to settle his team down as they've come out flat here in the second period. Although, after playing last night, you can kind of expect a letdown. Simpson's first goal of the season. We'll see if it becomes an insurance marker. The Ravens change up their faceoff alignment. Porcellato off the draw, and she scores! A knuckleball by Carly Porcellato beats Tisdale again over the glove. And the Gigi's cut the lead to one. A great faceoff, and we had mentioned how important those faceoffs were. 10 seconds after the Ravens took a 2-0 lead, Porcellato's second goal in two games. And her second on the season. So talk about a weekend for her. And again, the Gigi's looking to set something on the faceoff as Watson, a defenseman, takes the draw and gets the forwards on the puck. Played out front, and we'll see if that brings the Gigi's to life as Wagner brings the puck to center where it's knocked in by Kristen McDonald. She chases down Watson. DeForge on the right side stops. Now Lefebvre. Tied up by Seiler. Whitener picks up the loose puck. She'll wrist it on net. She hit the crossbar. Must be something with that net in the Ravens bench area. That's been the third puck off the iron so far in the game. And now Kayla Lasseline's on a breakaway. Lasseline, her shot, she scores. Kayla Lasseline high over the glove of Stephanie Mercier, and the Ravens regain their two-goal lead. So after going no goals between both teams in the first period, they've combined for four already, and we have barely played 8 minutes here in the second period. 7:06, the time of the goal for Lasseline, her fourth on the season. I haven't had even time to check the assists on the other goals. 3-1 Ravens. Here, not even midway through the second period. And again, the Gigi's down by a pair. That shot steered in, and Tisdale makes the save. O'Grady picks up an assist, as does Bergeron. Porcellato, who has the goal. Paquette picks up an assist from her. It was Paquette that won the faceoff back. And Vanderveen and O'Grady had assists on Simpson's goal. So O'Grady with 2 points in today's game. The Ravens back looking for more. They had to get onside. Porcellato in her own end. Young poke checks it from her. Now it comes out into the neutral zone. Yeah, you lose. On the right side. Offside coming and can't touch the puck, so a faceoff. Coming back outside the Ravens' blue line. So quickly running through, opening the scoring was Kristen McDonald with assist to Seiler and McKnight at 3:12. Then at 6:04, Simpson with her first of the season from Vanderveen and O'Grady. 10 seconds later, Porcellato with a shot from the point after Paquette won the faceoff. And then Lasseline with assist to O'Grady and to Bergeron at 7:06, 3-1. And the Ravens are buzzing, looking for more. Mercier turns that aside. Turnover. Kent keeps it in. She's going to fire it high over the net. It comes all the way around. Vanderveen tries to keep it in, but loses it to DeForge. Beaver over to McDonald and quickly in, but BMAC didn't gain the red line. And faceoff will come all the way back into the Ravens zone. Coach Shelley Coolidge shaking her head that her team's failing to gain the red line before they dump it in. Paquette not able to win that draw. And it comes all the way around the far side. Kristen McDonald had flown the zone looking for a breakaway pass, but it didn't happen. Kristen McDonald behind the net. Moves it up. Now a pass onto the stick of Seiler, and it rolls in. Mercier is going to cover it up. And Coach Yannick Evola is looking for something as he's got a foot up on the boards, yelling at the officials. But the faceoff coming in the Gigi zone. Icing was indicated there. Even though Seiler touched the puck, she was on the defensive side of the red line. But when Mercier covered the puck, that negated the icing. Kristen McDonald gets run over by Reinholtz. Now Stanish spins behind the net. Loses it to Wegner. Wegner on the backhand dishes it to McDonald. Behind the net. Wegner high off the glass to Seiler, who's in the corner. Seiler behind the net for K-Mac. Picking up the loose puck is Porcellato up to Morrison and quickly onto the stick of Bouchard, who plays it in. Now behind the net, Reinholtz. The Ravens able to get it out, and it's onto the stick of Delange in her own zone. Her pass didn't connect with Bouchard. And now Watson will carry it up. 3-on-2. Watson carries in. Poke checked by O'Grady, but she continues on with it. She stops behind the net, tries to wrap it around, and Tisdale will cover it up. 9:38 to go here in period number two. 3-1 for the visiting Ravens over the host Gigi's. Face off to the left to Tisdale. In net for the Ravens. Trails only Charlene Labonte in goaltending in the Quebec Conference. We'll see if that helps gain her a nomination for a All-Star selection. Those will be coming out later this week. All the coaches will vote after the regular season. A shot from the point. Beats Tisdale through the legs. I may have cursed her as Jen Delange picks up the second Gigi's goal. Delange first goal on the season, so she joins Simpson as first-time goal scorers. We'll have to wait and see who the assists go to, as it seemed like a broken play. Puck came back to the point. Delange just wristed it in, and it beat Tisdale, possibly through a screen. Carrying it in now, Beaver, as the Ravens have twice blown two-goal leads, but they keep coming back for more. B-Mac will pinch down low. No Ravens there. They had headed off on a line change. Puck high into the air. Icing waved off. So LeClaire picked up one assist. Porcellato now has the puck bounce off her stick, so she has to play it around for Standis. Standis loses it to Simpson, plays it through the crease, but nobody there in a black jersey. Bergeron lost it at the point, not to hustle back for it, as DeForge was right on her. Puck dumped in, no icing called. So back for it will be Standis. She'll set it up, and that puck gets deflected high over the glass, and the faceoff will come outside. 8:10 remaining here in period number two. It's been goals coming fast and furious here in the second period. 3 by the Ravens, 2 by the Gigi's, and that is our score. Paquette off the draw, kipped it up, trying to get it to Delinardo. Puck dumped in now by Sadie Wagner. Kristen McDonald, who opened this floodgates of goals here early in the second period. Seiler out front. Watson careful not to tip that in her own net. Wegner, that shot blocked by Paquette. It'll head to the other side of the ice. Kept in at the point. Wristed in by Plude. Now McDonald in the corner. Plays it softly behind the net looking for Seiler. Wegner on the backhand. Watson stopped that. And she'll pass it up to Delinardo. Delinardo off the boards. Monick slowed it down, but Delinardo still able to get it out. Now Seiler on the back check. Vanderveen rubbed out behind the net, trying to wrap it out front. was Blomberg. Back to the point, Watson. Watson, one move around Seiler. Watson carries it in. Her shot. And she just sent it wide. Looking to add to her point total as one of the top rookies in the Quebec Conference this season. Watson, shot, misses the net. But the Gigi's have control, and the Ravens defender is getting very tired. That's high up in the air. It's caught. Now it's dropped. About 10 bodies there. Back to the point. That shot tipped. Tisdale. It's underneath somebody. And finally a whistle. As I lost the sight of the puck about 10 seconds ago. As there was just a maze of bodies in front of Tisdale. But she was able to find the puck and hang on to it. Caulfield picks up the second assist on Delange's goal. Face-off will come to the right of Tisdale. LeClaire wins it back. Porcellato fires another one in. Baseball swing by Caulfield. Now back to the point, Standish. Over to Porcellato. Tried to get it away quick, but it got blocked and came out into the neutral zone. BMAC over to her D partner, Beaver. Turned over, Standish poke checked that. Beaver followed it up. Got it into the neutral zone, and now carrying it in is Young. She turns it over, and it's flipped into the Ravens bench, and that'll give us a whistle. With 6:04 to go in our middle period here at the Sports Complex, the Gigi's and the Ravens. Ravens up 3-2. Make sure you come back early in the second intermission. We'll take you around the CIS, update you on all the scores and the goings-on across the nation. Very exciting time. Two conferences, Canada West and the OUA, in the first round of their playoffs. It's getting to be crunch time. RSEQ will start next week. The AUS, one more week of regular season, and then their playoff tournament the first weekend in March, all leading up to the national championship at the University of Alberta in Edmonton, running March 8th to 11th. Myself, Stuart Bowden, and our entire SSN crew will be headed out to Edmonton to the Claire Drake Arena. I got some pictures from their sports information department on where we will be set up, and it's going to be a great tournament in a very historic venue out in Alberta. I'm just praying for warm weather. I've already started packing the long johns. At the point, Watson. Played down for Paquette. Her shot hit a pair of shin pads. Came back to Watson at the point. Paquette, she'll whine and fire. That one got through, and Tisdale made the save. Again, Watson at the point. Watson over to Boucher. Boucher's shot blocked and off the end boards. DeLonardo leaves it for Paquette. Boucher, Watson, wrist shot. Looking for the tip there was DeLonardo, but it's blocked by BMAC, who just fires it off the boards to Kent. Ravens looking to get a change. As you could hear, assistant coach Miguel Filiatro yelling deep so they could get a change, and they do. Watson, pass for Paquette. Now the Ravens hoping they can catch a tired Gigi line. Kristen McDonald back to the point. Beaver and O'Grady had a little bit of confusion on who was going to take the puck. Boucher off the boards to Blomberg. Blomberg's going to start moving it out. Gives it to Watson over to Boucher. Now back to Blomberg, looking to DeLonardo. DeLonardo fanned on it. And as they were changing, way too many GGs in the offensive zone before the puck got in. And we'll get a nice side call. Face off in the neutral zone. Bergeron pointing at DeForge as DeForge was back playing D. Now she's in on the puck. Vanderveen makes a move. Now plays it up. That pass. Bergeron got a piece of it off the pass from Troy. Bergeron right into the slot. Mercier covers it up, and getting run over there in front of the net was Vanderveen. after Bergeron took the original shot on goal. Faceoff will stay in the GG zone with just 3:48 showing on the clock here in the second period. The fans making a lot of noise trying to cheer the GGs on. A nice crowd for a nice Saturday afternoon here in our nation's capital. Winterlude going on, the last weekend of it, but it's become more like Waterlude after some mild temperatures this week have basically melted all the snow and ice in town. Coming the other way now is Pouliot. She mishandles the puck and it goes into the Ravens' end. Now turnover. Pouliot backhand was trying to hit LeClaire. Now Vanderveen slowly plays it up. McKnight joins the rush. She's down the right side. Tries to toe drag it. A la another famous GG number 19, not 91, hot tot. Now Pouliot comes the other way. Her shot. Tisdale makes a save. Follows it up with the rebound. And going hard into the net was Pouliot. And she's down as the net came off. And that'll get her whistle. Erica Pouliot took that shot on goal and followed up the rebound. And then got run into the net, and I believe the faceoff will stay inside the zone. Pouliot back up and headed to the bench. We'll keep an eye on her, and they're going to say she didn't get pushed in as the faceoff comes outside. Off the faceoff, quickly up through the middle. Cindy McDonald carries it in. Her shot deflected in on Tia Marley now in goal. I apologize. I missed that change, and now the GG net came off. I must have been writing something down and did not even notice the goaltending change for the GGs. I apologize. Tia Marley now in goal for the GGs. Second year nursing student out of Kingston, Nova Scotia. She started yesterday's game at the Ed Meagher Arena in Concordia. And as mentioned, was lifted after giving up 4 goals on 24 shots. Another faceoff play for the GGs is this time they flipped it high into the zone. And they gave chase. They're on the attack now. But the Ravens able to pick up the loose puck. Banged out front. Tisdale gets her glove down and covers that up. And now a penalty coming after the whistle. It's going to be a roughing call, I believe, going against the... It's going to go against Delinardo by the looks of it, as all the Ravens are skating off, ready to get their power play unit on. And for the third time in today's game, the Ravens will head to the power play. They're 0-4-2 so far. Haven't really had a whole lot of setup. Seiler, Wegner, and McDonald out on the forward line for the Ravens on this power play. Kristen McDonald is actually with her goal already extended. Her goal scoring streak to 3 straight games. A puck high off the glass. And Sarah Seiler with her assist extends her point streak to 4 straight games. So a couple streaks continuing for the big line of the Ravens. And Marley made the save there and kicked it out right to Kristen McDonald, but got over to make the save. As a good opportunity for the Ravens on the power play. A minute 47 to go in the period. 1:25 remaining in Delinardo's roughing penalty. Bergeron against LeClaire. LeClaire able to win that. Now DeForge tries to clear it out. She finally does on the second opportunity on the backhand. And Lasseline has to go back for it. Over for Plude. Now quickly up to Bergeron. Bergeron gains the zone, but it's only momentarily as getting it out with Standis. Plude. Backhand pass for Lasseline. Drops it off for Blair McDonald. She tried to dump it in, but it hit DeForge's stick. They bang at it, and it's loose in the GG zone. That'll give them some time to kill off some valuable seconds. That puck stolen by Porcelato as she tried to carry it a little too long. Kristen McDonald turns it over. Back to the point. Plude, wrist shot, no traffic. Marley makes the save. Now DeForge picks up the loose disc, and she'll send it the length of the ice. 45 seconds to go in the period. Wagner now carries it in. She's got McDonald going to the net. Wagner with a shot and a blocker save by Marley as a bad change by the Gigi's allowed the Ravens to quickly move the puck up. Seiler goes to the backhand and just sends it wide. Delinardo standing up. She's ready to get back into the play. Kristen McDonald carries in. Back to the point. That shot's blocked. The Gigi's at full strength, but the Ravens still on the attack. There's Delinardo out of the penalty box. Standis tries to backhand it. Beaver pinches to keep it in. Now Watson plays it up. Caulfield tried to hit Delinardo. Delinardo tries to backhand it just to get a late shot here, but that's going to do it for second period, a period that featured 5 goals total. 3 by the Ravens, 2 by the Gigi's, including a goalie change on the part of the Ottawa Gigi's. So we're looking forward to a very exciting third period here on CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN. Make sure you come back and join us for Around the CIS during our second intermission. Welcome back to CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN. After two periods of play, the Carleton Ravens with a 3-2 lead over the Ottawa Gigis. It's now time to take a look around the CIS, and we're going to start in the OUA. They are in the first round of their playoffs, best of three series in all accounts here. It started on Wednesday. Laurier down Brock 4-2. Tammy Freiberger, two goals, and Erica Thunder, 11 saves on 13 shots for the Golden Hawks to put them up 1-0 in their series. That's the 1-8 matchup. Also on Wednesday, Western with a slight upset over U of T. Lindsay Gordensky with a goal and two assists, and Kelly Campbell making 36 saves in net for the Mustangs as they take a 1-0 lead over the U of T Varsity Blues. That is the 3-6 matchup in the OUA. That was the 4-5 matchup. The 3-4 matchup is Queens and York, and on Wednesday it was York posting a 4-3 victory. Catherine Tallis' goal at 9:21 was the difference. Megan Lee strong in net, 32 saves on 35 shots for the Lions. Morgan Mahaffey, a goal and two assists on the losing end for the Gales, putting them down 1-0 to the Lions. On Thursday, first game in the 2-7 series, saw Windsor head into Guelph and upset the Griffins 3-2. Jane Gaffney's second goal of the game was the game winner. Julia Orsasis made 28 saves in net. On Friday, game two of the Queens-York series, Queens rebounds with a 3-2 victory. Brittany Mahaffey's second goal of the game was the game winner. Mel Dodd-Meyer, 28 saves in net, and Morgan Mahaffey with two more assists. Games today, we'll see games two in the Guelph-Windsor series. Also game two, U of T at Western, and Laurier will be at Brock. If necessary, on Sunday, we know there will be a York-Queens game three. If necessary, Windsor will be at Guelph, Western will be at U of T, and Brock at Laurier. Should mention, Morgan Mahaffey was the leading scorer in the OUA. She posted 38 points to win the regular season scoring title. Also, in playoffs in Canada West, these are semifinals. In series number one, game one, the 2-3 matchup, Alberta down Saskatchewan, 4-2. Alberta had three third period goals. Alana Kendra had two goals. The game winner came on the power play, and Caitlin Chapman posted the victory in net, 20 saves for the Alberta Pandas, giving them a 1-0 lead. In the other series, the 1-4, Calgary, 3-0 over Lethbridge. Amanda Tapp, 18 saves for the shutout. Elena Gorvola, two goals, including the game winner, Haley Wickenheiser, two assists. Game two in both those series will be played on Saturday, and if necessary, game threes on Sunday. Important to note, if Alberta knocks off Saskatchewan, the winner of the Calgary-Lethbridge series gets an automatic bid to Nationals, as Alberta will be there as host, so that would put Calgary or Lethbridge into the National Championship. As mentioned in the RSEQ, one game last night, Concordia 6-2 over Ottawa. Alyssa Sherrard, two goals. Maggie McNeil, Alana Dorian with a goal and assist. Catherine Rancor, also goal and an assist. Mary Perrier, Rampard, Paquette, 22 saves in goal for the Stingers. It was DeForge and Porcelato replying for the Gigis. Only game today is Carleton at Ottawa. Two games tomorrow. Montreal will be traveling to Carleton. Concordia will be at McConnell Arena to play the Martlets. In the AUS, they're in their second to last week of the regular season. Two games on Friday. Dow beat St. Mary's 4-2. Jocelyn LeBlanc, two goals and an assist. Jenna Curry, a goal and two assists for the Victoria Tigers. Brittany McCacken, 27 saves for the victory. Interesting to note, this must have been a rough game. The Dow Tigers 1-for-10 on the power play, and the St. Mary's Huskies 0-for-10 on the power play. Other game in the AUS saw St. FX defeat Moncton. St. FX had five different goal scorers. Aaron Brophy had the game-winning goal. It was Brittany Perkins and Janelle Parent both adding a goal and assist. Kristen Garrell only faced 12 shots from the high-powered Moncton offense. Marie Poirier had two goals. Kathy Desjardins, 34 saves for the Aigle Bleu, and that will give St. FX first place in the AUS with only 1 week remaining in regular season play. They do a regular season playoff tournament, so that will give St. FX the advantage as finishing first. Games today in the AUS, Moncton will be at Dow. St. Thomas heads to the Keating Center in Antigonish for meeting with the X-Women, and Mount Allison will be at UPEI. St. Thomas will be at St. Mary's on Sunday to wrap up the weekend. And that's our look around the CIS. The GGs and the Ravens both back out on the ice, just waiting for the clock to finish running down. And then we will have third period action here. Five goals in the second period, giving the Ravens a 3-2 lead. Teal Marley now in net for the Ottawa GGs. And it's all of a sudden got very quiet in the arena as they're waiting for the time to run out so they can reset it. And you should see better ice conditions here in the third period as the ice was done long ago, had lots of time to set up, so both teams shouldn't have to worry about any puddles. Referee Jeff Demers blows the whistle, wants to get this game underway. They're going to let the clock run all the way out. There's the buzzer, and they'll reset it to 20 minutes. Or 19:55, clock's already running. There we go, we got it set, and we're underway with third period action. Stuart Bowden from the sports complex at the University of Ottawa. A final regular season game for the home GGs as they prepare for the playoffs with a matchup against the McGill Martlets still waiting on the schedule. Should congratulate the GGs men's team as they will advance to the second round of the OUA playoffs after defeating the Nipissing Warriors 2-0 in their best of three matchup. And that's partially where the scheduling quirk comes in. When you have two teams that play out of the same rink in the playoffs, McGill Martlet's also in the same situation. So a lot of ice juggling have to be done. Alicia Blomberg carries the puck into the Ravens zone. She stops, dishes it off to Paquette. Now Lasseline behind the net, up to Vanderveen as she carries that in, and she'll dump it in. Marley will set that up. And the GGs head the other way. Pass through the middle, hit the stick of Young. Played over to an open side by BMAC. And now carrying down the right side, Sidmack. Sidmack, her shot, and Marley kicks out aside. Paquette able to get it over to Standish. Standish on the backhand, got away from the check of Yalouz. Using her feet to get it out was DeLonardo, and she'll head off for a change. Standish avoids the oncoming rush of Sidmack and then runs into her own player, Ashley Caulfield, but the puck loose, Pouliot. Didn't think she was onside, so she took a little bit longer route to the puck. Back to the point. Pouliot played it back. Delange kept it in. But now it'll come out to center. Over to Watson. Watson slaps it in. Tisdale set it up behind the net. Pouliot. It's high up over the net. They bang away at it. Caulfield. That was an interesting play as Pouliot actually lifted the puck over top of Tisdale to the other side. Lasseline fires it in, and the Ravens will head off for a change, as will the GGs. Watson carries to center. McDonald trying not to hook her. That pass right on the stick of Reinholtz, and then she takes Beaver into the end boards, and Beaver takes her down, and Beaver is going to get penalized. As the Ravens touch the puck, the whistle come, and Beaver better be careful. I could hear she wasn't too happy about that call all the way up here. So Reinholtz takes her into the end boards, but Beaver gets the retaliation penalty. So for the first time in today's game, the Ottawa GGs will head to the power play, looking to tie this game up at threes. LeClaire is going to get thrown out of the faceoff. Lefebvre's going to come in to take it. And that didn't work too well for the GGs, but it ends up they keep the puck in the zone. LeClaire circles and dishes it over to Fanny DeForge. Pass from Choyne to Watson. Puck movement. Big shot. And Tisdale followed that pass around. And DeForge makes the save. Ottawa ranks just slightly above Carleton in power play percentage. They're at 18.5%, 12 goals in 65 chances, one shorthanded goal against. But Carleton's penalty killing has been atrocious this year. 73.3%. They've allowed 20 power play goals in 75 chances. And you can see there the first shift for the GGs is they were just able to move the puck at will. Watson, long shot. That's tipped, and it goes wide. DeForge quickly on it, plays it back to Watson. Over to DeForge, now over to Choyne. Choyne fanned on it as she tried to one-time it, and Plute able to clear it down. Marley out to set up the puck for Watson. Dumped in and played out into the neutral zone. Back to get it. Now will be Blomberg. Blomberg trying to avoid Seiler, forces the turnover. That shot into the stomach of Watson. And now the Ravens just keeping the puck in the GG zone where they're killing off more of the clock. Boucher, dangerous pass through the middle. Jumped over the stick of Paquette. O'Grady all the way back in her own zone. Fires it back in. Maybe my little dig at the Carleton penalty killing has helped him here. As ever since then, the GGs have yet to gain the offensive zone. Now Pouliot carries in. O'Grady picks up the loose puck, battling against Blomberg. Vanderveen will lift it the rest of the way. And just 10 seconds remaining in the penalty to Beaver. Now Reinholtz with a head of steam as she carries down the left side. Ravens back at full strength. Puck skipped over the stick of BMAC. Now Reinholtz trying to get to the front of the net. It's loose. Tisdale makes one save. Now Bergeron gives it away. Standis, her rolling shot. It's loose in the crease. And finally, Carleton able to settle it down as Tisdale had to make two incredibly tough saves on rolling pucks. Stick slides into the corners. The puck's tied up along the boards. And a whistle. 14:34 to go. Carleton still up by a goal here in the third period, trying to salvage this series matchup against the GGs. The GGs are 4-0 in games against Carleton. In games against other teams in the queue, not so good. 2-13. So if they could find a way just to schedule nothing but Carleton games, they'd sit in first place. And a penalty coming here. It's going to be an interference call. Melanie McKnight heading off. So just like we saw in the first period, after Ottawa killed off an early power play, they went right back to the penalty kill. So now it's Ottawa's turn to go back to the player advantage after Carleton just killed off a power play. And Yannick Ivola wants to talk about how much time on the clock. Unfortunately, I don't know what kind of argument he's going to have. It's his home team scorekeepers. A And now they're talking to the scorekeeper. We'll see if they change any of the time. And they're going to keep the faceoff in the Ravens zone. So maybe a little strategic move by Coach Evola just to rest his top line here. He's got LeClaire, Lefebvre, and DeForge. Watson and Choyne back on the back end. They move the puck around. Watson at the top of the umbrella. That shot gets through. And the Ravens able to knock it out after the puck got blocked. Choyne on the right side. Now cross ice for DeForge. DeForge fake cutting the middle and stays outside. She circles the net, protecting the puck as she goes. Back to the point to Watson. Over to Choyne, one-timer, off the crossbar again. The fourth time in today's game we've seen the puck go off iron in this end of the rink. So that faceoff should be outside, or it's going to stay inside. Interesting. I guess they're going to say that it was tipped at some point. Minute 20 to go in the penalty to McKnight, one of the Ravens' best penalty killers in the penalty box. They win the draw. Plude plays it over for O'Grady. Sid Mack tying up with DeForge. And right away, 3GG's trying to dig it loose. LeClaire over for Choyne. She's watched there by Lasling. She gives it away. And that puck shot the length of the ice by Plude, and the Carleton fans here that have made the trip across town applaud that effort. Offside as DeForge had jumped. 13:07 to go here in period three. The Ravens with a one-goal lead. Twice they've had two-goal leads, only to see the GG's answer. Face-off won by the Ravens. Vanderveen pushes the puck forward. Now the GG's able to get it in their own zone. Pouliot will dump it in. Caulfield trying to be first on it, but the Ravens get it and get it out. Now a one-on-one, Bergeron and Delange. Bergeron makes a move to the inside, and coming back to help support there was Bouchard. They get it up into the neutral zone. The Ravens are going to send it back down under 10 seconds to go. The penalty, and here's a turnover. Bergeron cuts in, and a save by Marley as that pass was intercepted. A dangerous pass by Watson, and coming out of the box there is McKnight as the Ravens have killed off the second power play. So specialty teams, not a difference in today's game so far. Young down the right side with a head of steam. Pass out front, but Kristen McDonald was not up there yet as she was heading off on a change. Cross ice looking for Young, who's buzzing all over the ice. Chelsea Young just playing in her fourth game here with the Ravens after playing a couple years ago at Oakville, former member of the Oakville Ice Junior team. The Ravens turn the puck over, and now Blomberg cross ice onto the stick of Delnardo. Delnardo's shot deflected high up in the air, and it'll go in against the end boards. Blomberg spins, cycles it low for Paquette. Paquette out front looking for Blomberg. She was tied up there by Sidmack. Gigi's heading off on a change, allowing Beaver to carry the puck to center. A little confusion there with the Gigi's as they bumped into each other during the line change. Porcellato had the first GG's goal. Both GG's goals have come on shots from the point. Porcellato and then Delange. Right now the D for the GG's are stuck behind their own goal line. Now back to the point, McKnight. Pulls to the middle, tries to set up the shot, dishes it off for Simpson. She plays it out front, high up in the air. Marley dives for it, and even though she gets spun around, she hangs on to it, and Porcellato goes down hard. And she's slow to get up. 10:40 remaining here in period number three. the final GG's regular season broadcast of the season. Make sure you join us for all the playoff coverage here on the Streaming Sports Network. Check the listings to find out when the first game will be. Off the faceoff, another set play. DeForge carries that in. Bad angle shot, may have hit the outside of the net. Plude off the boards for looking for Seiler just behind her. DeForge takes that pass off the skate and played it behind the net. Interesting, Stephanie Plude who's got the puck there with that pass. And the one earlier off the boards that went behind Seiler wasn't a very good angle. She's a civil engineering major. I think she'd know a thing about angles or two. I'm only kidding, Steph. She knows. She's smarter than I am, that's for sure. There's a glove or blocker save by Tisdale. Now Wegner on the right side, off the glass. Dumped in Watson, pressured by Seiler. Now the GGs come to center. Standish just, or Delaney, sorry, has it knocked off her stick. Ravens go D to D and then look cross ice. Split between Lasseline and Vanderveen and goes all the way into the GG's territory. Long pass right on the tape of Pouliot. One-on-one against O'Grady. O'Grady stands her up and no interference call there. Pass out front, they score! LeClaire ties the game at three as she buries that shot through the five hole of Tamara Tisdale. And at 10:51, it's a whole new game here as we're tied at three. I'm not sure who made the pass out front, but it was LeClaire who buried that puck. We'll have to wait for the official announcement, but LeClaire's fifth of the season. And only our first goal here in the third period, but it's a biggie. As it's tied the game at three, and Ottawa on the attack looking for more. Blomberg goes to the backhand. It's loose in the crease. Tisdale gets her mitt on it and covers up. Face off will come to the right of Tisdale. Caulfield and Pouliot pick up assists. So Ashley Caulfield, the one that made the pass out, and that Tisdale leans on the net and knocks it off. Ira LeClaire out of Varney, Quebec. Maybe in one of the bigger goals she scored if the GGs can pick up a W here. Paquette and Lasseline, a pair of threes again on the draw. A little bit of physical action beginning now, and as Kent fires at the length of the ice, an icing call. Interesting that nobody even chased that puck. He just knew it was an icing, and everybody stood there and waited for the faceoff. So Tia Marley in net for the GGs snuck in on us and has not allowed a goal and has allowed the GGs to get back in this game. Looking for the season sweep. Delange. Long pass, that shot, and Tisdale saw that the whole way, made the save. I have to get my stat man, Mr. John Bauer, on that to see when the last time the GGs swept the Ravens in a full season matchup. May go all the way back to the 2003-04 season when the GGs won the Quebec Conference title and Carleton was still a technically a club program that played in the QSSF along with McGill and Concordia. That puck sent in, and Marley will take no chances now as she covers that up and hangs on. 7:50 to go here in regulation time. These teams have played a little bit of extra time already this season. Will we see it headed for more? Back on October 22nd at the Ice House, they went into a shootout. And on November 19th, both also at the Ice House, they went into overtime. That was the Fanny DeForge goal on the set faceoff play. That puck's banged in the crease. Tisdale did the splits and kicked it out. Back to the point. Shot was blocked. Porcellato didn't get all of it. Now Plude chips it away. Played away. Reinholtz back for it. Bergeron runs here into the boards. If we had one more seven there, we'd do great at the slots. Shot blocked by Marley. Now coming the other way, Reinholtz. Lasseline forces her into Beaver, and Beaver knocks the puck into her own end. Lasseline got Bergeron through the middle, just let her too far. And Bergeron will head off on a line change. Watson back to pick up the puck. Quickly played it up. Deflected off Bouchard's stick. Young goes behind her net. McKnight with a nice little back pass. And Reinholtz is going to take a penalty as McKnight went down hard. And McKnight lost a glove and a stick. So Carleton to their fourth power play of the game. 0-4-3 so far in the contest. Faceoff moves all the way back into Ottawa's defensive zone. One of the new rule changes they brought in this year. No matter where the penalty occurred, faceoff comes in your zone. Plude passes over to McKnight. Her shot got deflected and just slid wide. Wegner leaves it there for Seiler. Seiler looking, feeds Plude, gets it back. Seiler, one-timer blocked by Watson. Plude keeps it in, directs it in on net. Marley saw that the whole way and made the save. Wrapped around the far side. Seiler keeps it in, but Watson follows it up and dumps it down. Tisdale will come up and set it up. McKnight leads the rush. Lasseline falls, and the puck right on DeForge's stick, and she'll send it down on Tisdale. Tisdale leaves it there for BMAC. BMAC behind the net. Now comes out front, dishes off on the left side to Vanderveen. She couldn't handle it. DeForge, Lefebvre was screaming. She wanted the puck out front. She was wide open. DeForge couldn't get it to her. McKnight through the legs of Bergeron. Now Vanderveen, her wrist shot high up. Marley dives for it, and two players go crashing over her, but the puck's not underneath. Bergeron dishes it off. That puck shot wide. 35 seconds to go in the penalty to Reinholtz, and the GGs will get another change as they ice the puck. McDonald, lead pass up. Beaver backhands it in. No attack for the Ravens, but they're able to keep it in. O'Grady over to Beaver. Beaver's wrist shot blocked by Watson. Watson now off the boards, and LeClaire's going to give chase. She had to make a nice move, and O'Grady with a nice defensive play in order to throw out that attempt. Reinholtz out of the box, and we're back to even strength. Paquette, pass over, and that shot taken by Choyne was blocked by Tisdale. Choyne picks up the puck again, tries to walk out of the corner. McDonald now. Seiler fires that in. It went high. I thought it was going to end up going into the bench. Now behind the net, we've played 16 minutes of 20 here in the third period. We're tied at 3. The GGs and the Ravens in the final edition of the Canal War for the 2011-2012 regular season. Puck is underneath Vanderveen. They're able to dig it out. Pass comes out front. Plude lets it go to Young. Steered in on goal, and Marley poke checks that away. Pass across. 1, 2, 3, 4. 6 players on the ice. No call by the officials. Behind the net, Pouliot spins away, tries to get it out front. It's loose. Tisdale's down. They still bang at it. And finally a whistle. And the Ottawa GG's lucky to get away with that, as they had 6 players on the ice and no call there. 3:14 to go, and this is crunch time for both teams. Off the draw, pass over, and Porcelletto one times that just wide. Bouchard plays it below the goal. B-Mac off around the boards, now through the middle to Bergeron. Bergeron through the middle, last lane, and Porcelletto just sends it back in, forcing the Ravens to go back once again. Beaver for Vanderveen, off the boards to Bergeron. Bergeron softly dumps the puck in. Marley sets it up, and now the GGs come the other way. Delange plays it up, now through the neutral zone. It comes back to Watson. Watson over to LeClaire. LeClaire, who's got the tying goal in today's game. Trying the left side are the GGs. Blomberg flips it in. O'Grady back for it, but she went the wrong way around the net. That allows DeLonardo to pick up the loose puck. DeLonardo on the half boards. Backhand pass into the corner for Morrison. Back up top to the point. Watson had to take it on her backhand. So she plays it back low to DeLonardo. She's watched by Seiler. DeLonardo with the puck on a string now as she hangs on to it. Morrison back to the point to Watson. Watson uses her mask to keep it in as it got poke-checked by Wegner. Morrison. Good shift by this GG line of puck control. Watson, her shot, and it goes high over the net. Blomberg back to the point. Delange. Blomberg on the half boards, plays it down low into the corner, looking for DeLonardo, and the Ravens finally able to steal the puck from the Garnet and Gray, and they'll lift it down the ice and head off on a change. Marley sets it up for Watson. Watson circles, gives the puck away. Now Marley got out of her net, and she had to scramble back. Out front, Marley makes the save. Delange. And now it's the Ravens' turn to get the GGs trapped in their own zone. Watson softly off the boards for Choyne. Gets it to the blue line, and that's it. Here comes Jalouz. Now the GGs, DeForge comes to center. She carries in, makes one move and takes a shot, and Tisdale makes the save with 1:03 here. Left in regulation, could we be looking at a little bit of bonus hockey today here on the Streaming Sports Network? And Fanny DeForge, assistant captain for the GGs, will signal a timeout. And all the GGs head out on the ice, grab a knee right in front of the bench. Coach Yannick Ivole makes a... drawing up a play on the whiteboard. Shelly Coolidge got her troops all together. Tamber Tisdale off to the side, not listening in to what Coach Coolidge is saying in her own little world, per se, as most goaltenders are. Carleton jumped out to a 2-0 lead in the second period on goals by Kristen McDonald and Brittany Simpson to see Ottawa tie it 10 seconds later. Carly Porcelletto, they set a 2-goal lead again, Kayla Lasseline, but 2 goals on the strength of shots by LeClaire and Delange. I've tied this at 3, which is where we stand now as we line up for a faceoff to the right of Tamber Tisdale. in net for the Ravens. It's going to be Lefebvre, DeForge and Pouliot up front, Watson and Choin, and they're going to load up the front. DeForge tried to go forward with the draw. It's tied up. Now Vanderveen's got a rush down the right side. Under a minute to go. She cuts to the middle, waiting for troops to join her. Pass was looking for Bergeron. High up into the air. Watson plays it through the middle. Pouliot's pass deflected. It goes over top of Choin. Now Lasseline jumps in. She's got Krista McDonald going to the front of the net. McDonald still tried to get a stick on it. Choin down low, leaves it for Watson. Watson on the right side to Lefebvre. One touch pass to DeForge. She steps around Seiler. Plou tries to stand her up. And she runs DeForge into the board. She goes down hard. McKnight coming the other way. Krista McDonald. She's going to have to hurry if they want to get a shot here before the final buzzer. And it's played out into center. Brittany McDonald, or BMAC, plays it in. And with that, at the end of regulation, we're tied 3-3. The GGs and the Ravens, both teams will pick up a single point at least. Not that it will matter in the standings, as both teams are set in their playoff positions. Just a little bit of bragging rights here. If they can get a overtime or a shootout winner. Ravens still do have their timeout remaining. GG's having already called it. Just a one goal in the third period. Ira LeClaire at 10:09 from Ashley Caulfield and Erica Pouliot. Carleton's three goals coming in the second period. We'll play 4-on-4 for 5 minutes or less. Sudden victory. And I'm sure a lot of the GG fans, family, and teammates would like to see one of their vets that were honored before the game, one of their graduating players, if they can get the game winner. Overtime underway now here at the sports complex. Porcellato carries it in. She'll slam it off the wall. Beaver back for it. Leaves it there for O'Grady. Blomberg in on the forecheck. Beaver spins away. Uses O'Grady. O'Grady with a pass through the middle for Seiler. Two on two with Kristen McDonald. Seiler cuts to the outside. She's going to shoot. And an easy save from Marley as she took that right on the GG logo, right on the front of her jersey. 29 seconds have elapsed here in period number four. Bergeron. There was that set play, but McKnight read it as she stood up. DeForge at the blue line before the pass got to her. DeForge wires one, and Tisdale had to go off her blocker and go high over the net. That would have been an interesting one to end the game. DeForge carries in. Here goes backhand. Rebound. And that net gets knocked off as Tisdale tries to cover up the puck. And now we played 51 seconds of overtime. Faceoff will stay inside the Ravens zone. A howitzer of a shot by Fanny DeForge. And Tisdale took that off the blocking arm. If she didn't, it would have ended this game. Off the faceoff. Beaver plays it around, but BMAC wasn't able to get there. Neither was Jalouse. Now BMAC's got the puck. Up for Lasseline. Now LeClaire has it. Jump over her stick and outside the blue line. Pass over on the stick of Delange. Moves it over to Watson. And now three GGs to center. LeClaire carries it in. Watson goes to the front. That shot's blocked. And now the Ravens will come the other way, but Blomberg is on the back check. The Ravens dump it in. Marley couldn't slow the puck down as it was dumped. Standish now makes one move around Wegner. Standish leads a pack of GGs to center ice. And now in. She loses the puck. Kristen McDonald can't knock it off Porcellato. Porcellato shot blocked. Standish was on the other side calling for the loose puck. McKnight as it got caught in the referee's feet. Now Wegner gets over her line. It's poke checked away by Porcellato. Blomberg spins away and she'll head off on a change. Choyne had that shot go off the glass. Blomberg ran into her own player there in the form of Choyne, and then she dives over Sidmack, and now it goes into the bench. And Sydney McDonald heads off. She was a little bit injured, I think. She shakes it off. 2:35 to go here in regulation time. Fanny DeForge has the OT winner for the GGs early on in this season against Carleton. Let's see if she can do it again. That shot, Tisdale made the save, and then everybody got a scare from Plude, who almost put it in her own net. Pass was looking for Seiler, just out of her reach. Kristen McDonald spins away, tried to split through the D, and now the GG's lifted up to Forge. Thought about playing back, but she went forward, and she'll dump it in with a little bit of mustard. Quickly on the attack, Lefebvre. Lefebvre loses it, and it's back out to center to Porcellato. Both teams fairly cautious here in this overtime period. Only seen the 1 3-on-2 rush. Porcellato round to Standish. Now through the middle for Caulfield. Caulfield off the boards. O'Grady keeps her in front of her. O'Grady along the boards, spins, puts it up on the dashers. It almost hit a stanchion and came out front, and Tisdale wouldn't have known where it was. Poked out front, Caulfield spins, her shot goes wide. At the point, Delange keeps it in. Knocked down. Now Bergeron's going to send it the length of the ice. It's right on net, so Marley has to move it. But Delange picked up the puck, tried to feed Blomberg, ended up on the stick of Plude. Under a minute to go here in overtime. Lasseline down the right side. Intercepted there by Paquette. Paquette coming down the left side. She'll dump it in behind McKnight. Plude cuts her off on the far side. They pin it along the boards. And finally, referee Jeff Demers has seen enough. He blows the puck dead. 36 seconds to go. Could be headed to the always fascinating skills competition known as the shootout. The Ravens have played in a pile of extra period games this season. And now trying to get a break is Kristen McDonald. LeClaire back for it. Behind the net. LeClaire now able to move it up. One move by LeClaire to the outside to get around BMAC. BMAC regains defensive position and takes the puck away from her. Seiler lifts it out, but she's not going to be able to do anything with it. And with the buzzer going, we're headed to a shootout. As mentioned, Carleton has played in two overtime games. As we need to shut that clock off. Thank you. They've played in 4 shootouts. They have three shootout wins and a loss, and they were 0-2 in overtime. So now question comes, who's going to shoot in the shootouts? Sarah Seiler's 0 for 4 for the Ravens. Claudia Bergeron 1 for 4. Sadie Wagner 1 for 2. Melanie McKnight 3 for 5. And Sydney McDonald 3 for 5. The only other shooter to shoot was Alex Monk. For the GGs, you can figure DeForge will be a shooter. They've only been in one shootout. She's 1 for 1. Valerie Watson, 0 for 1. Dominique Lefebvre, 1 for 1, as is Ira LeClaire. While Carlin Chow, Jess Bouchard are 0 for 1, and Janie Paquette is also 1 for 1. Our shootout is the best of 5. In the shootout win over Carleton, Caitlin Fowler was the goaltender of record. Where Tisdale has been in net for every shootout so far for the Carleton Ravens, including a shootout victory over the McGill Marlets. So it seems that the GGs have elected to go first, and it appears Valerie Watson is going to head out. She has to wait for the officials to set the puck up. So Watson 0-4-1. Bad ice here, so my recommendation in a shootout has always been to take the shot. Watson carries in, fakes a move, goes to the deke, and she scores! She got Tisdale to freeze on the fake shot, and Watson goes to the backhand and goes upstairs. Melanie McKnight coming out as the first shooter for the Ravens. She likes to go shoot 5-hole, so Marley has to be aware of that. McKnight picks up the puck, carries straight in. Head up, looks to shoot, and a glove save by Tia Marley, as McKnight may have missed her spot trying to go low. Now number 9, Carlin Choring coming out. Also 0-4-1, but so was Watson, and Watson buried a backhand. Watson picks up speed, tries to go 5-hole, and Tisdale makes the save and knocks the net off for good measure. Claudia Bergeron now out for the Ravens. 1 for 4 on the season, Bergeron over the blue line. Fakes, and she lost the puck, and Marley made the save. As Bergeron, little too fancy stick handling. So after 2 rounds, the GGs with a 1-0 lead. Fanny DeForge, the next shooter up for the GGs. DeForge's got a heavy shot. Let's see what move she tries to make. Carries in, goes to the forehand, and Tisdale gets the leg out. And again, that net pops out. Been hit with too many pucks off the post today. It's finally had enough. Sarah Seiler, the captain for this Ravens squad, she's yet to score on the season in a shootout. Could this be the time? She carries in against Marley and goes top shelf and destroys the water bottle. That is a highlight shot as Sarah Seiler goes high over the glove hand and the water bottle explodes. We will be sending that to every media outlet in the country, as that was incredible. Janine Paquette now, as we're tied at 1. Paquette carries in, fakes, goes to backhand, and hits the post. The 5th time The puck has hit that post or crossbar at that end of the ice. So after four rounds, we're tied, one apiece. Sydney McDonald coming out, staring down Tia Marley. Sid Mack, lots of stick handling, lifts the leg, goes the backhand, and did she undress Tia Marley? What a move. Sydney McDonald with a 2-1 lead, and Dominique Lefebvre, the fifth shooter for the GGs, must beat Tamber Tisdale. Sid McDonald, a magician with the puck. Lefebvre picks it up. She's going in full speed. She's going to go right through Tisdale, and she scores! Lefebvre goes to the backhand, and we're tied. This game doesn't want to end. Extra shooters now. Sadie Wagner out. Wagner picks up the puck. Carries in against Marley. Goes to the backhand, and Marley steers out of side. And Wagner runs over the lines person standing in the corner. Yannick Evola questioning on if he can reuse a shooter. And even the referee not sure, goes over and asks Shelly Coolidge, as her team's been in a lot more shootouts this year. And she shakes her head, so indication is no. So now Watson sent back out by Coach Evola. Missed in the first round. Did score on the back end. She was the first shooter. Tisdale read it this time and made the save. Seiler back out to shoot now. Can she match her highlight film shot from earlier? Seiler takes the same path, looking for glove, and this time tried to go blocker side, and Marley was ready and got the leg out. Janine Paquette can win it here for the GGs, our seventh shooter. Paquette missed earlier. Carries in, goes to the outside, looking to deke, and she scores! As she slides it through the five hole of Tamber Tisdale, and the Ottawa GGs with a 4-3. Or not. Because the GGs shot first. Oh, too many shooters, I'm confused. But the GGs have the lead. McKnight must score. McKnight carries in against Marley. And McKnight scores. So we're tied again. I do have dinner plans. I would like to get home sometime tonight, but apparently all the players want to stay here, and Paquette's coming out again for her third shot. Paquette, same path as before, goes the outside, looks to go to the deke, and this time Tisdale makes the save. It worked once, it wasn't going to work again. Sid McDonald out for the Ravens, a chance to win it. Slowly picks up the puck off the dot, lots of stick handling, fakes, makes a move, and one too many as she didn't get much on the shot. As Marley makes the save, Now Erica Pouliot, her final regular season game here at the sports complex, and the fans realizing that, they come to life, even their own teammates. Stan and supporter Pouliot cuts in against Tisdale, goes to the backhand, and she scores! Tisdale's been beat on Deeks all to the glove side on the backhand. Kristen McDonald now out for the Ravens. She must score to force another round. She goes way outside, looks to cut in, and she does! And she got Marley to go down and put it over top of her. And I've lost track how many shooters we are, but we are definitely in double digits. Fanny DeForge out for her second shot. Another graduating player. DeForge picks it up. Tries to make a move, loses it, and Tisdale gets the leg out far enough and runs her out of room. Claudia Bergeron now out to shoot for the Ravens. Another opportunity for her to win it. Both teams have had the opportunity, either with a shot or with a save, to win the game. Bergeron cuts in. Her shot, she scores! And that will do it. Claudia Bergeron gives the Carleton Ravens the shootout win and their first victory of the year over the Ottawa Gigi's. A very entertaining game here at the sports complex as we had at least double digits shooting into the shootout. Both teams will head to the playoffs. The Ravens one more game to play as they will host the Caravan de Montréal at the Ice House tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock start. You can catch that here on the streaming sports network. The Gigi's will face the McGill Martlets in game number one of their RSEQ semifinal matchup, date still to be determined. Once they figure out the schedule with both the women's and the men's series. But make sure you check the website for all the details, as we will have coverage all the way through the RSEQ playoffs and into the national championship. The Ottawa Gigi's line up to salute their fans for the last regular season time this season. They fall to a record of 6-13 and 1 on the season. The Ravens improve to 9-7-3, but as mentioned, both teams locked in their spots for the playoffs, the Gigi's in fourth and the Ravens in third place. So for myself, Stuart Bowden, and our entire SSN crew here in the nation's capital, thank you for joining us for CIS Hockey Tonight on SSN. The Ravens with a 4-3 shootout victory. We'll see you in the playoffs.